How do you find like the optimal capital structure for a company?
Isn't that okay? I guess like in order, the optimal isn't just highly dependent on the, I have no idea. Like, I don't know where I'm supposed to go with this question.
What do you think the optimal capital structure means?
Like the percentage of debt and the percentage of equity.
Right, but like, so think about that in the context of WACC.
Oh, whatever minimizes the weighted average cost of capital then.
Right, okay. So how do you get to the optimal capital structure?
Well, isn't it, okay, so then don't you just like take the weighted average cost of capital and minimize it like to the lowest possible degree, like what the creates the lowest value?
So like, yes, in theory. So like in practice, how would you do that?
I don't know.
Take on more debt? Would you reduce debt?
I would probably take on more debt because there's like a tax shield on the debt, if that's what the question is asking. I'm not sure what the question is asking.
There is a tax shield on the debt, but is that the only reason why taking on more debt is better for capital structure? Like,
Well, I think probably not. Normally, like the cost of debt is a little bit lower than the cost of equity. And also normally it's a little bit less risky.
Cost of debt is lower than the cost of equity because it's less risky. Less risky for who?
The company, not the lender. Wait, I'm thoroughly confused by the question. Sorry.
So
it's basically asking like, what's the cheapest way that you can fund the company with? So basically, what is the cheapest source of capital? Is it going to be the equity? Basically, like if you fund the entire company with equity, you're essentially going to be giving up the profits, which potentially can be infinity, right? And then let's say you're taking on debt, the maximum cost of debt that is going to be is what the bank is charging you. So let's say it's like 5%. That's basically going to be the cheapest option in this case.
So cost of debt is lower than cost of equity. So in theory, if you are choosing between the two forms of funding, like the two ways to fund your business, it would be cheaper to fund it with debt, right?
Yeah.
That's the first part of the question. And the reason why it's cheaper to fund with debt is what Stanley just said, because you're not sharing any of the upside in your business when you fund with debt, right? You're not like giving a percentage of the ownership away to your equity investors, right? Instead, you just go out and borrow the money and you have to pay that money back eventually, and you pay a small interest expense on it, right? So like cost of debt is lower than cost of equity first and foremost, because you're, and this comes back to the thing that you were saying, is like it's less risky. And I asked you for who, it's not less risky for the company. I would say debt is more risky from the company standpoint, because with debt, you can't actually default. And if you default, then like you go bankrupt, right? With equity, like I can give you a percentage of the ownership. Like there's no risk of me like, you know, going bankrupt just because I gave you a percentage of my business. I just have a smaller piece of the pie, right? It's less risky for the debt. For the lender, it's less risky for the debt investor. Between the debt, from the investor's point of view, would you rather be the debt investor or would you rather be the equity investor? Well, if you're conservative and from a risk standpoint, the debt investor is taking on less risk because the debt investors always get paid back first before the equity holders. Like if there was a liquidation event, if the company was going to go out of business, like they would have to like sell all their assets, get as much money as they can, take that, pay their debt holders first, pay them back for the principal that's owed. And if there's anything left after that, then it would go to the equity holders. But usually there's nothing left after that, right?
Yeah.
So they're senior to the equity holders on the preference stack. And so like they're taking on less risk. And so like the law of investing is that high risk, high reward, low risk, low reward, right? If you're taking on more risk, you need to be compensated for that risk. Therefore, you're going to require a higher return.
Yeah. Right? Just really quick though, like how does this like answer the question? Like, how do I figure out the exact like breakdown of cost of cap, like between debt and equity, right? Like I know like.
So I was going to get there, but like that was going to be the follow-up question, but we haven't gotten there because.
Oh, okay.
The way you get to the optimal capital structure is by finding the inflection point when your weighted average cost of capital is at its lowest point, right? So the question would have been like, when is the weighted average cost of capital at the lowest point? Because in theory, like if you really think about what WACC is, if you understand what WACC is, if you have no debt whatsoever on your balance sheet, then you should take on some debt because you go from being 100% in equity to being partially in equity and partially in debt. And your cost of debt is going to be lower, so your weighted average is going to come down, right? Yeah. That part makes sense so far, right?
Yeah.
At some point, though, technically you can just keep doing that and keep taking on more debt, right? Then you say, like, well, why don't I just make it 100% debt and 0% equity then? Then, like, I'm going to have the lowest cost of capital ever, right? But in reality, you can't really do that because beyond a certain point, you start having too much debt. When you have too much debt, it means you're not going to be able to like service your debt obligations. You're not going to be able to pay the interest payments on time. You're not going to be able to like make the mandatory debt repayments when they're due. And that, again, that's when you go bankrupt, right? Mm-hmm. So even when you take on debt, there's like different debt investors that loan you money with different terms. Like they come in at different times. Like some came in earlier, some came in later. And then like the people that come in later usually sit lower on the preference stack, which means they get paid back like later, right? And so they're getting paid back later. They're taking on more risk, which means they're going to charge you a higher interest, right? So actually like as you take on more debt, your cost of debt is also going up because the later debt that's coming in is going to charge you a higher cost of debt, right? Does that make sense?
Yeah.
And then also like once you get to a certain point, if you're starting to have too much debt, like your company becomes distressed, or like people start worrying like, oh, this company has a lot of debt and they only have this much in cash flow. Like, are they going to be able to pay this back? Then like your cost of equity also starts to go up because now your equity holders are worried because they're like, well, we don't get paid back until all the debt holders get paid back. So if like shit hits the fan and the debt holders can't get made whole, then we get nothing. Then our investment is wiped out, right?
Yeah.
So basically like it's a curve. It's like if you graph along the XY axis, the X axis is like amount of debt, percentage of debt in the capital structure. And then the Y axis is like your weighted average cost of capital. Then it looks like a U shape and your optimal capital structure is like at the very trough of that U shape. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty much it.
Oh, okay. So it's just like, okay, I got it. Yeah.
Do you get it?
Yeah, I was going to say like that it's just the derivative of the equation, but I don't know if like, I'm pretty sure that's what you mean by the trough of the, yeah, it's just the derivative of the equation, right? But I didn't know that's what you're supposed to say because I did not see like anyone ever mention like the derivative in like anything. Yeah, it's just.
I wouldn't explain that way. That is like the mathematical way of explaining that. And Christian says, yes, it is. And like, you know, Christian majors in astronomical engineering. So it's just like, you know, like for the very mathy people, like that's going to make sense. But for just like a business or a finance major, like a banker who like, you know, didn't major in math, like if you just say, oh, it's the derivative of the whatever, it's just like, it might not really register, right? So you have to explain it conceptually, business terms, like I just did, right?
Okay.
So basically, long story short, like one sentence summary is just like, cost of debt is lower than cost of equity. So you ideally, you want to have like some percentage of your capital structure being debt because it's going to lower your weighted average cost of capital. But then like once you get to a certain point, I mean, there's a limit to that. Beyond a certain point, if you start having too much debt, then your cost of debt actually starts to go up and so does your cost of equity. So then like that point where it goes from like being a positive to a negative, that's like the optimal cap structure.
Yeah, I got you.
And it's gonna be different for every company. It's not like, oh, at 45% debt is optimal. Like, no, it just depends on the financial profile of the business.
Yeah, got you.
Cool. Hey there, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you're looking for more customized advice that's tailored for your specific situation, then I invite you to book a free strategy session with our team at the link below. We'll talk to you soon.